for example, in this patient, we don't know, they say he's deteriorating. He might have some impairment, cognitive impairment as a result of the uremia maybe. So let's say if he was refusing dialysis, for example, I'd be really skeptical because I wouldn't know if he was making that, if he was in his right frame of mind to make that sort of decision.
Great. So the question is, it's important to evaluate to see if the person is competent to make the decision. Okay, keep going here. So the next principle is justice. So the principle of justice is really the idea of being fair and treating all cases or all persons alike. So we want to treat others equitably, and in similar situations and conditions, want to treat circumstance, it's someone who doesn't have health insurance. They're not on the NHS. These kids are going to be on the NHS.
To make it accurate in our setting, because NHIS doesn't cover much, maybe you can see someone who has a corporate insurance.
Thank you.
wanted to study was he said, boy, because I wonder what it's like in Africa, in different African populations. And this is an interesting thing because there is more diversity of human genomes in Africa than there is in all of the rest of the world put together. If we think of the human genome as one, if we think of, let's say, European genomes as one set of genomes, genomes in that there are about 5 or 6 equivalent different types of genomes in African populations. So a huge amount of diversity in Africa. It happened to be the case that for one of my hepatitis studies, my graduate student had enrolled about 800 people of Somali descent in Minnesota. And so he said, you know, do you think we could test these samples that you have to see if we will see any new variants in the 5-FU metabolism pathway? And of course, when the patient signed up for the study, we had in the consent form, that's another dimension of ethics here, in the consent form, we had added a statement where the patients gave us permission to use their samples for genetic analysis. If we didn't have that, we couldn't have done this study. But we went ahead, Dr. Diaz did a study on the patients. And remarkably, he found 8 new variants in this immigrant Somali patient that had never been seen in any other population in the world. And so then, of course, his next step for his team was they actually then were going to make all of these new variants in the gene to see if they made a difference to how well 5-FU was metabolized. But that meant that all the Somali patients that were coming through Mayo Clinic that we were treating with 5-FU, we no longer had no idea whether how they would respond and whether we were actually doing something that was beneficial to them. So this non-maleficence has different dimensions. But one of the dimensions is increasing the amount of medical knowledge for the population that you are treating so that you can be sure that you're not doing harm. So here we have a case of a 22-year-old, GABA 3 para 2 person with preeclampsia. She deteriorates and the 33-week gestation reaches baby develops severe bradycardia. The first year medical officer performs an emergency C-section at 3 a.m. He's never done it before, and the mother dies in the OR. The infant survives. The father blames the doctor for his wife's death. So the question, has the physician breached the do no harm principle?
Ascribing the course of a medical
medical misadventure can be difficult. And maybe that's another reason to think about ethical committees. But ideally, this would be something where whether it's the anesthesia, the surgeon, or nursing care, if you're in a situation where you cannot feel like you can do the required procedure, to a high level of quality, I think you would be cautious at the very least. Is that right? Again, Dr. Lane, any comments on this?
I think this is a tough one. I agree a first year medical officer probably should not be doing a C-section at 3 a.m. by himself, no matter what. The only thing here is that the preeclampsia, if she was deteriorating, she might have died anyway and then taken her baby with her. So was this the better of two evils? I don't know.
Challenging. So I think one final slide. We have time.